You know what I never knew would be so hard when I started working with an editor? Yeah, the quality of the edits are gonna go up, but revisions. Collaborating with somebody on my creative vision was kind of a pain. But lucky for me, Review Studio reached out and showed me how to take the painstaking, awful Slack message back and forth and turn it into a seamless workflow. So Review Studio not only works with videos, it also works with different types of file formats, whether it be images or PDFs and whatnot. But for me, I mainly work with video, and as you'll see here, what I was able to do is make a new review and title it based off of the name of the video. So three best ways to improve your productivity in 2023. And then from there, you can set a specific client. So this is just going to be internal. You can have it be a specific project. You can put some labels on it, and then you can have specific approvers as well. And I'm going to set a deadline to make sure it's reviewed by next week. And then after you've done that, you can upload any of the images. So I'm just going to go here and then browse files and select the video and then upload the file here. So then once we go into this and this is done, we can then click on this image and you're going to be brought into a review canvas that is top tier. So I can play through this or scrub through it just like anything else. And I can give positive feedback or negative feedback, whatever my thoughts are on the different parts of the video, and annotate it, which is way better than Slack messaging about it. If you want to know the three best ways to improve your productivity, so at the beginning of this video, I really like this. I think it's a really nice way to showcase things. And I'm going to circle this and put love this here and then post it. And then same thing for this over here. And then what I'm going to do is actually mention the fact that I want to arrow this. So I want this to be moved over here. Move this to the top left. And then I can draw more. And then say, and put another one to the top right. So now what we have when I press save is an entire scene where I gave positive feedback and some negative feedback on like, hey, can you move that? It's like, I don't like that it's in front of my face. Now, something that's really nice that I can be doing is when I'm making some of these connections between different drawing options and shapes, the draw more feature comes into play. So when using these arrows, I can point here and say, move this to the top left, and then draw more, and then move this to the top right. And then I'm in the draw more feature. So this number 6 right here is gonna keep extending this. So I can put, for example, a different shape here. So I can literally draw out what the squares would look like. And then by the end of this, you'll see when I press save, now all of number 6 is with these different items. It has all the different shapes that I drew. And then if I wanted to, I can change the color of whatever I'm working with. It doesn't have to be red. It can be any of these. So like be a white arrow. And I also can change to just do a location-based one. So I can just drop a comment on it. So for example, I could go here and just put use a mouse / keyboard image. And then I could obviously go through different parts of the video. But many people do not sit down and think, how can I be more productive in a tangible way? So for example, if you are sitting there thinking about how you can be more productive, sounds like a productive thing to do, right? I like the edit that he put in there with the specific thing where I went, But if you don't have any sort of tangible knowledge of the space, and I'm going through this video at 1x speed, but I can totally review it at something quicker or slower. So 1.5 for me makes a lot more sense. So I'm gonna scrub through this a little bit of productivity, and you're doing yourself a disservice. So first of all, what I'd recommend you in order to have quality system improvement sessions is to obviously watch content like this or read books like Deep Work and Atomic Habits. So this is something that was a new edit that my editor put in there, which I really like. So if I circle this and just let them know, great additions here, and then I could draw more to make sure that he understands. And then I would edit this to say, I specifically liked the roundedness of the images and the popping sound. Now, I want you to notice really quick here that it has an annotation and has the timestamp. And then attached to it, I could put an image on it, I could obviously edit it, and then even there, I can set a task. So for example, I can set a task for this image right here. So set a task and I could assign it to my editor and say, add extra image. And then the same goes for the rest of these. So move task to the top left and then post. And then once it would be completed, I could easily have my editor check this off and then press post and it would showcase that it'd be completed. Now you could add a note with it, but no need. A really cool thing about this then would be if I were to get a second rendition from my editor and I were to go to the compare button here, I would be able to,
if you want to know,
play these outside of Tandem, or then I could press sync navigation. So when I press play, it would both navigate at the same exact time. So if I press play here, you'll see them both go.
Three best ways to improve productivity.
Whoa, that's interesting. Now I will point out that right here, I ended up marking it as 0.75. So that's why the audio was kind of out of sync. So they need to be synced at 1x in order for them to be played in sync, or whatever speed is the same. So it could be like 1.25 and 1.25. So now I'm able to see side by side once an edit would be put into place after uploading another file. How is it improved? Is it what I asked for? And then even from there, I can be like, hey, you know, like you made the edit, but it wasn't quite what I asked for. Can you see the difference here? And that really helps me as somebody who's working with somebody else on a workflow like this to continuously get renditions. And then I can see that I actually have a spot here that shows me how many open tasks are there and how many comments I have, which is a great thing to have as an overview. So then now when like the last task would be checked off, I'd know that it'd be ready for approval. And these reviews are easily shareable with hyperlinks to other people, which makes this process even that much easier. I have yet to find a more intuitive workflow for having a back and forth with an editor. And this platform does exactly what I needed to take my video game up to that next level. Thanks again to Review Studio for sponsoring this video, and maybe up your productivity level even more by checking out this video right here.